Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to Digital Devil's Saga. You'll recall that we left off after having just defeated a group of cute little squeaky things, I guess? So let's head on into the area, and maybe I'll have an opportunity to demonstrate those skills I just equipped on Surf. Speak of the literal Digital Devil. How about that? So let's try out Ragnarok, because the defense down will help against those slimes. Not bad. Alright, and what did we get here for our Jiwa? Yes! Excellent, now she can equip 6 skills as well. God, every time! So, let's deal with that, and I think maybe some one physical attack and one magic attack probably would be good for her. Well, we'll deal with that in a moment, rearranging those. We'll say yeah, a single target physical attack would be good. And she's already got Gate of Hell, so damage relative to HP. I don't even remember how the random ones, I think, just I don't seem to remember that being a particularly good skill, but stun, fizz, moderate, light, moderate. None of those are really particularly good. You know, I forget what curse does, so I'm going to try that out, and we'll see what it does. Yeah. This should be good. I don't imagine too many of the enemies this early in the game are immune to curse. So, it seems that if you did not bother getting the blue key before you came back here, a lot of stuff would be off limits. Interesting indeed. So, I could have sworn one of those other areas was a spot where we'd get to experience some of those optional enemies, but I guess not. Gang Blast, a new combo, was discovered. Fantastic. Let's see what we get. Yeah, Gang Blast. Damn it! Light damage, physical, all. Okay. I completely forgot combo attacks existed. Surf pass, and heat pass, and let's see what Death Spray does. Oh, it's just one. Right, I should have been paying attention to that. Oh, that was silly of me. What was I thinking? So I think instead I'll give Argila something else. We'll give her some magic. We haven't seen a lot of magic yet. Flame Breath. I think that was Harley's skill, actually. Frost Breath. Bolt Flare. Shockwave. Avalanche. Megiddo. Yes, there we go. Interesting that MP Thief is considered to be a mute type skill. Very interesting. Last Word. You know, let's try this out. Well, that's right, and then there's Xanadu. So many spells to try out. Curse, Death type, all. Alright, well, I guess that might have been what I'm looking for, so we'll give that a shot next. Whoops, that can go there. There we go. I think this might actually be... Oh, well, it's at least an item. I was gonna say, I thought it might be a shortcut somewhere, but nope. Just an item, I guess. Another great chakra. Fantastic, that's 10,000 maka for me.
I'm sorry, I'll make this quick.
All right, Surf can pass, Heat can pass. Let's see what Blood Curse does to these guys. Well, so much for that then. Why did I even bother? Really? Sometimes I question my own tactical judgment. In any case, let's see here. I've gotten all turned around now. Right. Ah, damn it. Oh, look who it is! It's Nozuchi! Although I think he has a different name in this game. Nope, it's still just Nozuchi. Alright. Ragnarok it is, then. Oh, look at him. He rolled over. That's cute. How is that little bugger supposed to eat anybody with just a sniffy little trunk? I don't get it. Yes, fantastic. So now Heat can equip a couple of new skills. Let's deal with... God, we'll deal with that now. I wonder, is there a way... No, there is no way to remap the controller. I don't know why I thought there would be. That was stupid of me. Why would they let you do something that makes sense? Alright. Well, Heat could certainly always use some additional physical skills. So, yeah, I think, Whoops. I think, There we go. Ragnarok and Revelation are appropriate for this. Using this one a little bit more often, probably, so I'll keep it closer to the top. Somebody is probably poking fun at me for my obsessive-compulsive arrangement of my skills in the skills menu. Yeah, go ahead and laugh. But at least I know I have everything right where I want it.
Come on, your ass is mine.
I mean, not that that probably matters too much in this game, because I have input memory set. So, who knows? Whatever. I'm sure it'll be okay. God, that guy. It seems like so far, almost all of the enemies we've been fighting have been just tiny little things that go squeak. Except for the... Ah! That's right. I forgot about this. I don't know why they do this. This is just meant to scare you, I guess? Or to waste turns? Although, I think these guys will eventually attempt to drain your MP, at which point they will be able to cast Teradyne, and you're in a lot of trouble. I want defense down. There we are. But yeah, boy is that a great troll where they start casting a Dine tier spell. And then it's just, oh, insufficient MP. Gotcha. Really pretty evil. I like it, actually. Oh, right, and the rooftops. I don't remember if this is progress or just bonus. I think it's just a side area. Yes, indeed, that would appear to be the case. It doesn't seem like an enemy that tiny should be making such a bellowing elephant trumpeting sound. It seems like that would be another one of those little squeaky things. Oh, and I guess the path continues then, so... Ah, yeah, okay. What I thought. So, in this case, the switch is fairly well removed from the gate. So this is indeed progress. Voices can be heard whispering. I thought they'd be food by now. Looks like they aren't as weak as we thought. Yeah, thanks for your vote of confidence, guys. And this is another element of the level design in Digital Devil Saga that sort of... I'm not sure whether it's a result of or a cause of the fact that the dungeons here are all procedural or not procedurally generated. They're fixed layout. I mean, I guess they just kind of go hand in hand, but because all of the dungeons have fixed layouts, they sort of make them longer by forcing you to go out of your way to solve puzzles. Whereas in Persona 3 and 4, they would rely instead on the fact that the dungeons are procedurally generated. So they would just throw a fairly large number of floors at you, and you get what you get floor-wise, but there's no real puzzles to solve. For the most part. I could definitely use that health, so I'm gonna go Vitality. Okay. So back down we go, and I guess the only other path from here is the path of progress. Yeah, because that's the way we came from. This is the way that we were supposed to head before. Yeah. So out we go. Oh, but there's more. Every one of these doors I find, I keep thinking it's going to be one of the doors that leads to bonus enemies. And I've fallen flat on my face every time I've made that guess so far, but eventually I'll be right. And I really would like to show off some of the fights with these bonus enemies, because the way they handle them in this game, where you think back to maybe Persona 3 and Persona 4, where it's just a question of chasing down a golden hand and managing to kill it before it, or they, run away. This game uses a very different mechanic, which I began trying to explain in the previous episode, and really did a very poor job of articulating. A presence can be felt beyond this door, so I guess this is just going to be another mini-boss. But the way it basically works... Oh, nope, it's another one of these. He just pissed off. The bonus enemies in this game... I think some of them are random encounters in certain areas. I think that might be how the enemies like Omoikane work. But the other, I guess, bonus enemy is the Mitama, which are Ara Mitama, Saki Mitama, Nigi Mitama, and Kusi Mitama, I think. Those are bonus enemies in Digital Devil Saga. And those are kind of puzzle-based. What'll happen is, you'll walk into a room, And... oh, but it looked like there was another way I could have gone back there. Damn, I shouldn't have gone this way. You'll walk into a room and there'll be, I think, an event point or something. Oh, and... they got the jump on us, but good this time. Which I guess is fine, because we still have all of our battle abilities. We're still immune to attacks. I think I'm just going to use guns for this fight. And we can see here that Heat... he has a grenade launcher, which I believe always does fire damage. And Argila has her sniper rifle, which I think has an incredibly high crit rate. God, surf with that freeze ammo. But what'll happen with these bonus enemies is you'll interact with an event point, and the event point will trigger a sequence where you have to run around collecting items. And not items that get added to your inventory, but, like, you collect little event items. They're just points of light on the field map, basically. And it's kind of like a time trial race, where you have a very limited amount of time during which to run a very particular circuit, collect all these points of light. And if you collect all of them and make it to the end of the circuit before your time runs out, the Mitama enemy will appear, usually in a room, and you can then interact with it at your will and fight it. That's if I'm remembering correctly. I might or might not be misremembering or mixing up some element of that. I'm sure somebody will not hesitate to correct me if I am. But that's how the fights with bonus enemies in this game work. And then there's another bonus enemy, which is Omoikane, and you'll remember him as a Persona from Persona 3 and Persona 4. He's different. I believe it's just a really rare encounter, but he only appears in certain rooms. And if you do manage to fight him, the only attacks that are effective against him are guns. Everything else, I believe, he'll just nullify or dodge. And I don't remember which is which, but I think... okay, yeah, I should have come here first. I think that the Mitama enemies give you a lot of... Atma and Omoikane gives you... yeah, here he is! Speak of the freaking devil! Once again. So, yeah, he'll just spam debilitate. Yeah, he's totally immune to everything. We're going to have to revert. The only thing, I believe, that does any amount of damage to him is guns, and he's probably going to run away this turn. Yup. And he has his own bonus boss, or, like, not boss, but his own bonus battle theme as well. And that's... it's really tough to kill him, as you can probably tell, but I believe he gives you tons of karma. And I believe... I should have thought of this when I was actually fighting him, but... I believe the way to deal with him is... and you can only, I think, get one shot against him, one or two. You have to have Surf revert immediately, and then have Heat and Argila pass their turns. Or have at least one of them pass their turn, so that the turn then defaults back to Surf, and Surf can shoot him. And that still leaves you with only that one shot as your chance of defeating him. So, I guess that kind of worked out in the end. He showed up at exactly the right time. I couldn't have asked for better timing there. And maybe with a little bit of luck, because I know there are some encounters with Mitama enemies here in Manipura. So with a little luck, I might be able to find those and show them off either in this episode or the next one. The thing is, I don't remember if they're walled off behind those energy barriers that I can't break. So I guess we'll just have to figure that out as we go along. And I think I am going to save once again here, because I do not really remember where, other than the fact that the actual boss of this area is behind gate 4. Oh, for goodness sake, these reinforcements. I have had about enough of these guys. Oh, look, they're all petrified. How about that? Watch this now, completely miss. Nope. Totally missed. Foolish of me to even try. They're immune while they're stone. They're not immune to this, though. This is one of the problems, though, with, This is one of the problems with the press turn system, which is the name of the battle system in this game. The problem is that since your top character in this ranking, this party order, will always act first, if your first character kills everybody else in one hit, then the second and third characters will often not end up getting turns at all. And I mean, yes, you can solve that by just having the first character pass his turn, but it's just one of those things that in situations like this, it can lead to you forgetting what skills you have equipped. So let's go to magic, and we'll give her... Ah, yes, Fire of Sinai. This is Metatron's special skill, and you might actually remember it because I believe it returns in both Persona 3 Fez and Persona 4 Golden. So, I believe the Persona Metatron can actually use this, and... Mega Damage and Ailments. Yes. She has just enough MP for Celestial Ray. And of course, you might have seen it already, but good old Marin Karin. God damn it, Mitsuru. So, plenty of returning skills here. I think Celestial Ray is better for groups, but Fire of Sinai can end up being better for individual enemies. And actually, I think instead of Dia, we're gonna just... We're gonna just go with the super high tier healing skill, which is pretty stupid because I only have enough MP to use it twice, but it's fine. What could possibly go wrong? I'm sure everything will go completely according to plan. Presence can be felt beyond the door. 50-50, they just leave again. But no, I don't believe they will. I think this one is actually a fight. Yup. Ambushed again. You know what? Screw it. Oh, and they're all weak against guns. Check this enemy out, though. It's a bird. Just a bird. With a sword. It's called Matcha. Huh. Oh, wonderful. Null attack even makes you immune to mute type skills. That's fantastic. interesting that he actually uses a grenade launcher when he is shown in the intro of the game as using a machine gun. God, this would get really annoying without null attack. Oh, and that one is stunned. Fantastic. Just, grenade it up. Yeah, and it's kind of strange that some demons just have guns as their weakness. It isn't even always special enemies. Sometimes it's just normal enemies that you run into are just weak against guns. Voices can be heard whispering. Oh, they're very strong. We'll need more men. You know, you guys could just stop trying to kill us. That might go a little bit better than all of these shenanigans. All right. I swear, one of these side doors, one of them, is going to lead to a bonus fight. All right, let's show off Fires of Sinai. Or Fire of Sinai. It's pretty cool. Tell you what though, thank God for Auto Soma. Because burning through MP like that... Nothing? Really? Are you sure? You know what? This might actually be the end point of one of those bonus fights. That move is so cool. Okay. Well, I guess the only thing for us to do is to continue our exploration. We'll have to find out, because I do not remember the layout of this place at all. Okay, yeah, I think this is it. Because this hallway looping around like this, I believe this is one of the situations where... Oh, and an odd morsel. I'm sure that's perfectly safe to eat. Ooh, revival gem. Might come in handy, though I hope I won't need it. Oh no, okay. Maybe this isn't one of those areas then. Well, ah, damn it, I keep forgetting. That auto attack in this game repeats your last command. Or it can be set to repeat your last command, I think. I don't believe it does necessarily. All right. I do not even remember which route here is progress. I hope it's not this one, because I don't want to have to backtrack again. Oh, but of course, there's a save point. So much for that. Something's down there. Descend down the ladder. I think it's just going to be another mini boss fight, but the other's presence can no longer be felt. Boy, what a troll. right. There was nothing. Why would I think there was something? Aw, now he's frightened. Well, good. He got a level up. Let's see. Where is this taking us? Ah, this is indeed progress. It is as Janana said. You have already made it this far. She granted us permission to devour you if possible. This is odd. How was I unable to devour you? Maybe because the game won't let you because we're Asherahs. Oh. Oh, for goodness sake. More cute little squeaky things. I've always been rather irritated by cute little squeaky things. Especially when they go squeak. Oh, I see how it is. Okay. Oh dear. Oh, it's a Gyuki. All right. This is a demon form I would not mind having, I'll tell you that much. If you are playing through the game on your first cycle, and you don't have all of your mastered mantras from a previous game, this guy is no joke. All right, and another level up, fantastic. Yeah, that should do. Oh, and I got another point of strength. Excellent. Yeah, well, what did you expect? Oh, yeah, because now somebody's probably going to come along and eat him. Help me. Later. This guy. This gate leads back to the entrance. Ah! Janana's just beyond gate 4. Okay, but I still have to activate this gate, and again, I believe the switch is up top. So, we're at about half an hour now, and I'm going to wrap up the episode, but hopefully I'll be able to finish out this area next time. I look forward to seeing all of you then. Take care, everyone.